Paris is always a good idea. That line might be from another classic film, but it still applies to An American in Paris, which returns to theaters in January 2020 to kick off the TCM Big Screen Classics series. Presented by Fathom Events and TCM, the series brings classic films to the big screen so audiences can enjoy them as they were originally intended to be seen. Leslie Caron is one of the few actresses to star and dance with both Fred Astaire and Gene Kelly in the award-winning movie. Featuring the music of George Gershwin, the film memorably concludes with a remarkable 17-minute ballet. Still considered one of the triumphs of its genre. Aside from her laudable role, are little known facts about the French-American actress, dancer, and writer. Just before we get into it, do watch this video to the end, share with your friends, and smash the subscribe button for more interesting videos. She was trained to be a performer from childhood. Born Leslie Claire Margaret Caron on the 1st of July in 1931 in Boulogne-sur-Seine to Claude Caron, a French chemist, pharmacist, perfumer, and boutique owner, and Margaret, a Franco-American dancer on Broadway. Growing up, her older brother Amory Caron became a chemist like their father, while Leslie was trained to be a performer from childhood by her mother. She was trained in the National Conservatory of Dance and was hired by the renowned Roland Petit for his company. She began taking ballet lessons at age 16. Did you know Miss Caron was a ballerina in a Parisian ballet company before becoming a film star? It's obvious Leslie had good dance training from her early years, which reflected in all the films she made that featured her ballet talent. But she was more than just a trained dancer. She became a ballerina in Roland Petit's prestigious ballet company, the Ballet des Champs-Élysées. She was discovered by Gene Kelly. While dancing with Roland Petit's ballet company, Leslie was discovered by Gene Kelly, who, so impressed by her charisma and technique, offered her the role opposite him in the musical An American in Paris in 1951, a role in which a pregnant Cid Charisse was originally cast. This role led to a long-term MGM contract and a sequence of films, which included the musical The Glass Slipper in 1955 and the drama The Man with a Cloak in 1951 with Joseph Cotten and Barbara Stanwyck. Still, Caron has said of herself, "Unfortunately, Hollywood considers musical dancers as hoofers." She is one of the few actresses from the classic era of MGM musicals who are still active in film. In 1953, Caron was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Actress for her starring role in Lily. For her performance in the British drama The L-Shaped Room in 1962, she won the BAFTA Award for Best British Actress and the Golden Globe, and was nominated for the Best Actress Oscar. Caron has continued to act, appearing in the film Chocolat in 2000. During the 1980s, she appeared in several episodes of the soap opera Falcon Crest as Nicole Sauguet. She's one of the few actresses from the classic era of MGM musicals who are still active in the film, a group that includes Rita Moreno, Margaret O'Brien, and June Lockhart. Her other later credits include Funny Bones in 1995 with Jerry Lewis and Oliver Platt, The Last of the Blonde Bombshells in 2000 with Judi Dench and Cleo Lane, and Le Divorce in 2000, directed by James Ivory with Kate Hudson and Naomi Watts. Marlon Brando inspired Leslie's Cinderella for Ella. Leslie plays a very modern, spunky Cinderella in the film. Named Ella, this is the first film that Leslie sports her classic pixie cut in. Leslie says she does some of her best technical dancing in this film, and she's right. The dance sequences, which Leslie used her star power to get Roland Petit's company to perform with her in the film, are magnificent. The interesting fact about this film is Leslie's inspiration for her character. Her spunky Ella had the most unlikely muse. As Leslie shares, "One amusing note on my creation of the character of Cinderella. I was, like everyone else in Hollywood, under the influence of Marlon Brando's performance in On the Waterfront, which had just come out. His modern style of acting created such a revolution in Hollywood. Yes, I admit it. Ridiculous as it may be, my inspiration for Cinderella was Marlon Brando. The Brando Brood. Leslie's inspiration for Ella was Marlon Brando and his pouty method-style acting. Do you see the similarity between Leslie as Ella and Brando in this picture? Marlon Brando takes a moment to brood in On the Waterfront in 1954, striking a face not too dissimilar from Leslie's in the picture. Marlon Brando and Cinderella. An unlikely pairing, but hey, it worked for Leslie. Her Ella is quite literally perfection. And when you know Brando was her inspiration, it's fun to spot moments of Leslie's Ella doing the classic Brando brood in the film. The unbeatable accomplishment. Fast forward to June 2003, Karen traveled to San Francisco to appear as the special guest star in the songs of Alan J. Lerner, I Remember It Well, a retrospective concert staged by San Francisco's 42nd Street Moon Company. In 2007, her guest appearance on Law & Order Special Victims Unit earned her a Primetime Emmy Award. On the 27th of April in 2009, Karen traveled to New York as an honored guest at a tribute to Alan J. Lerner and Frederick Loewe at the Paley Center for Media. For her contributions to the film industry, Karen was inducted into the Hollywood Walk of Fame on the 8th of December 2009 with a motion picture star located at 6153 Hollywood Boulevard. In February 2010, she played Madame Armfelt in A Little Night Music at the Théâtre du Châtelet in Paris, which also featured Greta Scacchi and Lambert Wilson. In 2016, Karen appeared in the ITV television series The Durrells as the Countess Mavrodaki. The Unending Affairs. In September 1951, Karen married American George Hormel II, a grandson of the founder of the Hormel Meatpacking Company. They divorced in 1954. During that period, while under contract to MGM, she lived in Laurel Canyon in a Normandy-style 1927 mansion near the country store on Laurel Canyon Boulevard. One bedroom was all mirrored for her dancing rehearsals. Her second husband was British theater director Peter Hall. They married in 1956 and had two children, Christopher John Hall, a TV producer, in 1957, and Jennifer Karen Hall, a writer, painter, and actress, in 1958. Karen had an affair with Warren Beatty in 1961. When she and Hall divorced in 1965, Beatty was named as a co-respondent and was ordered by the London court to pay the costs of the case. In 1969, Karen married Michael Laughlin, the producer of the film Two Lane Blacktop. They divorced in 1980. Karen was also romantically linked to Dutch television actor Robert Wolders from 1994 to 1995. Though she had her downsides, Leslie remained a living legend with memorable dramatic and comedic performances. From her accomplished ballet work to her gamine, she made us root for her in any situation. So much so that when we want to watch a Leslie Karen film, we never want it to end. And that is it for this video. If you find this video interesting, let us know your thoughts about the Hollywood legend in the comments below. And don't forget to hit the like button, share with your friends, and smash the red subscribe button.